Hi, this is a really quick video with some great news on the phantom drain issue that many of you have been having. So stay tuned. Hi, John here. Even put my best shirt on for this. This is great news. So on the 15th of October, Thursday the 15th of October, yesterday, I received an email from Tesla, which I've been waiting for since mid-August. And it was confirmation that there was a problem with our installation, and it gave a solution. So let's sort of quickly wind back for those of you who are new to the issue, in case it's the first video you've seen. If you want to see the whole nine yards, then take a look up here at the previous video, card up there. So back in July 2019, I had two SMETS2 smart meters installed, one for the gas and one for the electric. I record the end of day readings for the house usage, grid usage, solar production, Tesla Powerwall in and out and so on. And those daily recordings give me a granular level of detail of data. And it's with this data that I noticed a massive variance between what the smart meter said we had pulled from the grid and what the Tesla Powerwall app said we had used from the grid. And this would range between about 2% difference between the two figures when we'd use lots of electricity to a massive 3,880% difference when we'd used very little. Yeah, you heard that right, 3,880% difference. So the Tesla app reported that we'd used 0.10 kilowatt hours of electricity from the grid in a 24-hour period, whilst the electric smart meter recorded 3.98 kilowatt hours of usage for the same day. Never once have the two readings agreed. So we obviously get billed against what the smart meter is saying rather than what the Tesla app is saying. So back in July 2019, I raised the issue with Tesla, my solar installer, my electricity supplier, Octopus Energy. I recorded two YouTube videos about it, created a detailed online report, posted on forums about it. And finally, 18 months later, Tesla have confirmed that there is an issue. So let me show you what Tesla say in the email they sent on Thursday. Now, if you didn't get the email, don't worry, as I'll include a link down below on how to register your Powerwall with Tesla and what else you need to do to report the issue if you're also having the same problem. I'll also explain how to check if you've actually got a variance or not, and whether your system's working properly or not. So onto the email. Dear Powerwall owner, we have received reports that under some circumstances there can be an incompatibility between the Tesla Powerwall storage system and the Landis+Gyr E470 100mm smart meter. In some cases, this may result in accurate utility meter readings and the impact varies, but could be up to plus or minus 5 kilowatt hours per day on some sites. The Tesla Powerwall is certified to all appropriate standards for home storage systems, and the problem only appears to occur on this particular model of Landis+Gyr meter. All other meters tested, including other models of Landis+Gyr meters, are unaffected. Where the meter has been replaced, no further issues have occurred. And they attach some photos or insert some photos of the meters so you can identify which one you have. We're working closely with Landis+Gyr and energy suppliers to ensure that this is resolved for Powerwall owners in the United Kingdom. If your energy supplier installed a Landis+Gyr E470 100mm utility meter at your property, we advise you to formally notify them through the complaints section of their website. For our records, we would also kindly ask you to register your Powerwall system with us through the link, down below, to follow up communication. Thank you for your understanding. Sincerely, Tesla. I knew back in the middle of August that Tesla had recreated the problem in their test labs, and I've been waiting for confirmation from this publicly, as it were. So, yeah, it's now public, which is awesome news. So, if you have a Tesla Powerwall 2 with either a Gateway 1 or Gateway 2, and you have a Landis+Gyr E470 100mm smart meter, I would recommend you check your usage to see if your setup is affected, if you don't already know. And as you just heard, there are variances between plus or minus 5 kilowatt hours per day. If you don't have these two items I've just mentioned, then you can basically skip along to the next video if you don't want to watch the end of this, because there's basically nothing here to see. So yeah, move along if you want to. However, if you have these two items, then consider this. The worst case scenario is if you multiply the 5 kilowatt hour daily variance by 365 days for the year, at an average price, unit price of electricity of, I don't know, 21 pence per kilowatt hour, that works out to £383.25. So you could be paying £383.25 over the odds. It's actually quick and very easy to check on the accuracy of your readings. There are a couple of options, and it will be slightly different depending on who your energy supplier is and how they, you know, supply that data to you. I'm with Octopus Energy, so that's what I'm going to show you. But the concept is exactly the same for all energy suppliers. If you have an online account, log on to that account, and that should give you a daily recorded usage for your system, i.e. what you pulled from the grid each day. And that will go back historically. Or, if you have an in-house display, you'll also be able to get that data as well. So that'll record daily usage. Probably won't go back as far historically as the online account, but for this purposes, you only need sort of 7 days or so just to have a look. Then, once you've got that data, compare that with your daily grid usage for your Tesla Powerwall app. If you find there's a variance, then Tesla recommend doing two things. Inform your energy supplier and ask them to swap the meter out. Follow the link in the Tesla email to register your Powerwall with them. And again, I've included that link down below in the description if you didn't get that email, so no problem. And obviously only do this if you have been affected by those inaccurate readings. If you haven't, then you can just ignore it. A couple of things. Before filling in the form, you will actually need a couple of photos. So one of your SMETS2 smart meter, and also a photo of the serial number of your gateway, be it a Gateway 1 or a Gateway 2 for your Tesla Powerwall. And these two photos are uploaded when you complete the form. Form takes about 20 seconds, so it's very, very quick and very easy. But that's the only bits of data you will definitely need to go and get beforehand. Anyway, great news are in terms of acknowledging the issue and providing a solution. I've already spoke with Octopus Energy back in August, and they've confirmed that they will be swapping the meter out and applying a credit to our accounts. So all good news there. So I would also suggest you speak to your energy supplier as well, talk about credit to your account. Any other questions, any other queries, then please drop them down below, and I will then pick up the comments and respond to them. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, comment, all of those good things for this particular video with its excellent news. And I will see you on the next one. All right, take care.